Hello everyone, welcome to my free online tutorial for the new SAT math section. Now the problem that you see on your screen right now is taken from the first exam, problem number 17. This is the official SAT study guide just released by College Board. So again, the first exam, problem number 17 in the no calculator section. Now this problem tests your understanding of geometry, precisely triangle similarities, and understanding its side relationships. So they give you the unknown quantity, the line segment AE, and they want you to find this segment using the properties of triangle similarities and the given values for the other segments that they provide here. So they give you a piece of information. The summer camp counselor wants to find the length x in feet across a lake as represented in the sketch above. The lengths represented by AB, EB, BD, and CD on the sketch were determined to be 1800 feet, 1400 feet, 700 feet, and 800 feet respectively. Segments AC and DE intersected B. Right, so from this information AC and DE, you know that ED are line segments and AC are line segments. So in other words, measure of angle ABC and EBD are 180 degrees. So they intersected B, and measure of angle AEB, which is here, and CDB have the same measure. So these two triangles, these two angles are congruent. They have equal measure. So now that you have one pair of congruent angles, you know that since ED and AC are line segments and they intersect at B, you have two vertical angles here, and vertical angles must be equal in measure. So you have two pairs of equal angles in this picture here, right? Two pairs of equal angles, and that means that these two triangles, BDC and AEB, must be similar. Okay, so now that they're similar, you know that their sides have the same proportion, right? So AE is related to CD by a proportional constant, some constant, and the same constant applies to a relationship between EB and BD and between AB and BC. So now that we know that, we can set up a proportion to find the length of line segment AE, which is given as x feet. So now that we set, we can have the first setup here. AE divided by EB, so AE divided by EB is going to be the same as CD divided by BD. So make sure that you do this correctly, because in other words, you see this angle here. This is a trick that you can use to make sure that you do it correctly. So if you choose AE over AB, you know that these are adjacent sides with respect to this angle, so that you know that if you choose AE in the first fraction, you must use CD as your numerator in the second fraction, and you know that the denominator of the second fraction must be the second adjacent side to this angle that is equal in measure to this angle, right? So you know that you're not going to screw this up. You're going to do it well. So AE over EB is the same as CD over BD, right? And this way you will not violate the property of proportion. So if you do this correctly, you set this up correctly, you will substitute the given values into this proportion. You will arrive at x divided by 1400 equals 800 divided by 700. You cross multiply, and then you get 700x is equal to 1400 times 800. Now you might say, how do I do this without the calculator? There seems to be so many zeros. You can leave this 800 number alone. You can work with 1400 divided by 700, and you know that this simply means 14 divided by 7, because you have the same number of zeros for 1400 and 700. So you're dealing with 14 divided by 2, which is divided by 7, which is 2, so you have 2 times 800 as a result, which gives you simply 1600 feet. So this is the length of segment AE. AE, line segment AE. Now, the second way of doing it, and there are so many different ways. There are so many different arrangements you can have when it comes to proportion for similar triangles. As long as you keep the rule of not messing up your order, right, of your sides, you will get the right answer. So in other words, here you can see I write AE divided by CD. So AE, I divide AE by CD, and then I choose EB for the second fraction numerator. And again, how do I know I won't screw this up? It's because EB is the second adjacent side with respect to this angle, right? So I already used AE and I divided that by CD. Now I'm going EB, that equals to EB, and I know that this is the missing side. So I must divide the EB by BD, right? Which is exactly what I did here. So again, this is a perfect arrangement. You will not make a mistake. You just have to substitute your values correctly into this second proportion. And when you do it correctly, you get 700x again by cross multiplying, 1400 times 800. And as a result, again, you work with 1400 and 700. Well, this is basically the same exact thing. You get x is equal to 1600 feet. That is 1600 feet. Okay?